Files.
Press start to begin.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the Super Bonus Round. We are back with more AI, the Somnium Files. I'm your host, John Mugiwara, JM, joined as well as my girlfriend and co-host, Christine.
Yeah,
well. And be warned, she says she's going to sneeze.
No, I thought I was.
You never know. Sometimes they might sneak up on you. Just when you think you got it, you go, and it gets you. Anyway, when we last left off, Iris got chopped in half by a halfway bear.
Yeah, she's not. She's happier than she used to be.
Yeah, she. Oh, it wasn't funny when I said it, but it's hilarious when you say it. That's not fucking fair.
Oh.
What, you thought I was gonna say bear, weren't you?
Yeah.
How bear you? Ha! Anyway.
Stay away from Tessa.
Otis showed himself on the stream. If he was going to kill Iris and then himself, why would he do that? The only reason you would show yourself like that is to prove that you weren't the culprit. Ota and the polar bear on the screen at the same time would prove that they're not the same person. That behavior would be totally unnecessary if he was going to commit suicide anyway.
Well, maybe he wasn't planning on dying at first. After he killed Iris, he realized that he couldn't live with himself.
So he lies down on the workbench and turns on the ice cutting machine himself? I don't buy it.
Maybe he was thinking like this. The reason Iris and I can't be together is because her agency prohibits it, making the president, Renju, the ultimate bad guy in his mind.
Mizuki is Ota's close friend. Do you really think Ota would kill his friend's father?
Shoko was married to Renju. Maybe he was trying to get at Renju by killing her.
That's a stretch. They've been divorced for years. Ota knows all about it. He wouldn't use Shoko to get to Renju. The culprit was wearing a polar bear costume, probably to hide their identity. But if murder-suicide was the plan, the costume served no purpose.
Exactly.
There are some additional discrepancies. I analyzed the investigation report. Judging by his wound, Ota was stabbed in the side by a kitchen knife or something similar.
Are you sure?
I am.
It's old boss that Aiba found.
Oh, I know that.
Well?
Ota could have stabbed himself. Maybe he thought it would be a fatal wound, but when it didn't work, he went for the ice cutting machine.
Then, shouldn't we have recovered the kitchen knife from the scene?
Maybe he threw it in the ocean.
Boss, come on. Ota goes out to the water, stabs himself in the gut, throws the knife over the side, then walks back to the warehouse?
Well, I wasn't being serious. I didn't think Ota was the culprit from the beginning. I was just playing devil's advocate for HQ.
Really?
Yes, really.
Anyway, Ota didn't kill anyone, and he didn't kill himself. Here's what I think happened.
Stay away from Tessa!
Ota knew Iris was kidnapped, so he rushed onto the scene. That's when he saw the culprit wearing the polar bear costume. He tried to fight him off, but ended up being stabbed in the side. He was weakened and losing blood at the culprit's mercy. The culprit forced him into the costume, then under the ice cutting machine. And then...
Then, who is the culprit?
I wish I knew.
We're up to 4 victims. But Ota was a special circumstance. He wasn't specifically targeted by the culprit.
Right. And he was the only one to not have his eye pulled out.
Is this the first route where Ota dies?
So focus on the 3 other victims.
I actually have no
Shoko,
idea.
Renju, and Iris. What?
Iris has died in 2 of them.
Connections.
If you find a connection between the victims, you find a connection to the culprit. That's the theory of investigation, right?
You think the new Cyclops killer is related to them somehow?
Maybe, maybe not. But it's a good starting point.
Momokumakura, Hitomi, Renju. This will eliminate the possible Mizuki.
Mizuki has the strongest connections with all 3 victims. Shoko and Renji were her parents, and she was close friends with Iris. She was good friends with Ota, too. But that's why I could never believe Mizuki would kill all four of them. Thinking of her as a suspect is ridiculous.
The kitchen knife.
Hitomi and Renji are definitely linked. They were high school classmates. And she did say that she met Shogo twice. But I can't imagine she would kill Iris in such a gruesome way. No matter what the circumstances were, it seems impossible to me. Renji and Shogo were connected to the Komakuras. But there's no connection to Iris.
Well, there is one. But it's the exact opposite. He loves Iris because he's a big fan of Aset.
So, Sujima. There we go.
Renju, Shoko, and So. There is a connection between Renju and Shoko through the Komakuras. But again, I can't see any clear link to Iris.
Yes,
well,
man.
Now we can. Me.
I know Renju and Shoko. And I'm connected to Iris. But I have an alibi. Aside from Shoko, there's no way I could have killed any of them. No, now that I think about it, Shoko too. I don't remember killing her. My memories from 6 years ago are missing, but I still have my memory of recent events. And if I start doubting myself now...
Date, I can say without a doubt that there is zero possibility you are the new Cyclops killer. I have been working with you for years. I know better than anyone that you are innocent.
Mayumi had motive for killing Iris and Renju. Mayumi hated Iris, and she didn't think well of Lemnisgate either. And since Renju is the president... Anyway, the weak point is Renju's ex-wife, Shoko. I can't imagine why Mayumi would kill her. And above all else, she would never harm her only son, let alone kill him.
But she had the kitchen knife.
I thought it over, boss. Of the people I know, I can't peg any of them as the murderer.
And no leads to pursue?
No.
Then there's only one thing you can do. Continue your investigation. Do whatever it takes to get the culprit. To get justice for the victims.
You're right. Got it, boss.
Well, so we have a bunch of places we can go to. The cold storage warehouse is one. Monday, no despicable time. Ignition was running, but I was still cold. The temperature hadn't raised much at all. Well, there's something on my skin, but the center of my body is burning hot.
It's Kagami! Oh.
Nothing so far.
Oh, not Kagami.
It's not the same guy.
I checked this place point by point, but didn't find nothing.
What's the camera? Clearly in
the workbench.
Iris and Ota were.
I am sure you are already aware of Ota's time of death.
Still wild to me that he got killed. He hasn't gotten killed at all yet.
About 3:30 in the morning.
And the cause of death.
Right. About that. Ota had a stab wound from a kitchen knife in his side.
Correct.
What was the exact cause of death? Was it the knife wound or...
I cannot determine that. I can conclude that the knife wound was at least close to being fatal. Even if Ota was still alive on the workbench, he was certainly on the verge of death. If he weren't already extremely weak, we would expect to see more signs of struggle.
Maybe Ota was trying to help Iris jumping at the criminal and led to a scuffle in order to end up with a knife wound in the side. Lost all his power to fight back. Forcibly put into the costume, then finally cut open by the ice-cutting machine.
But why? Why did the culprit put the costume on Ota?
Unknown.
Twice in the ice-cutting machine. Iris and Ota were sliced in two by this ice-cutting machine. Iris and Ota.
Iris's estimated time of death and cause of death have been confirmed. The video was not a recording. It was a live stream, filmed in real time.
Which means Iris's time of death is 3:20 a.m.
Iris also had her left eye removed.
Yeah.
And like Renju and Shoko, Iris's left eyeball has not been recovered.
That's cutting machine.
A video camera and laptop. This is what the criminal used to stream. All of these items have been bought from pawn shops and thrift stores. It would be difficult to determine a suspect from them. I have logged into the Wi-Fi in this warehouse. Okiura Fishery Co. Ltd. is listed as the owner. However, I found the password written directly on the router. Anyone who saw it could have used it. I have done some research. As the name suggests, the company is owned by the Okiuras. The same Okiuras we know. Renju's father created the company.
Another connection to Renju.
No, actually. Currently, Okiura Fishery has nothing to do with Renju. The company has been managed by office representatives for the past 17 years after Renju's father died. Renju holds no shares and is not involved in the management. In short, Renju did not inherit the company from his father, and it was instead given to other persons.
But it can't be a coincidence.
It certainly is suspicious. Date, we should get moving. Officers from the local jurisdiction are checking the warehouse thoroughly. We will not find anything of importance here.
Yeah, you're right.
You can ask CSI to inform you if they find anything.
All right.
Okay, and then what are you doing there? Oh, you just tell the policeman you're leaving. Whoops. You know if you find anything. I'll let him know then left the warehouse. When I left the warehouse, I saw Peter. Uh-oh. What is he doing here? He walked up to me while I was trying to work it out.
Date, I have to talk to you about something.
Huh?
About the original Cyclops serial killings.
Why this all of a sudden?
Because I want you to solve this case, Mr. Date. I want you to find who did this and bring them to justice. So, if I can help you, even a little...
Why didn't you say anything at Abyss?
The boss was there. I couldn't speak openly in front of her. So, I decided to meet you here.
All right. Let's hear it.
Earlier, I told you that I was completely certain the original Cyclops killer couldn't have committed these crimes. I am absolutely certain the original Cyclops killer could not have committed these crimes.
Remember I told you that I'm certain he couldn't have committed these crimes? Flashback. I'm absolutely certain he didn't commit these crimes.
I freaking love this game.
I'll start by telling you the identity of the Cyclops killer. Although, it's more accurate to say, killers.
More than one?
In the first series of killings, the culprit had an accomplice. One of them was born a murderous psychopath. The other is Rohan Kumakura, the previous chairman of the Kumakuras.
Which we learned a little while ago.
They each had a role to play. The murderer committed the homicide, and Rohan removed the eyeball.
Yeah, so... Rohan's not the one who does the killing, but he is the one who removes the eyeball. Okay, so there is no Cyclops killer. There's a killer and then somebody who picks the eyeball out. Why did the clay case get classified?
That... I don't know.
The details of the original Cyclops serial killings case have become nebulous over time. Even the official investigation material contains nothing of value. I am unable to draw any conclusions from them.
You really have no idea?
If I did, I would tell you.
Rohan.
18 years ago, Rohan took a woman's eye. She was already dead. He put his finger into her eye socket and gouged it out.
You saw him do it.
The reason why was simple. He was fascinated by women's eyes. Their beauty stimulated his greed and his desire to possess them. He needed
so like Yoshikage Kira from JoJo, except he had a thing with hands.
Driven by women's this instinctive hands. Impulse, he took the woman's eye.
Yeah, he would pretend he's on a date with them, but like it would just be like their hand.
A grotesque obsession with the eyes of dead women. He was very particular about his need that the eye belong to a deceased woman. But even being the head of a Yakuza gang, there weren't too many opportunities for him to indulge. His deepest, darkest desire went unfulfilled for years. However, he soon met his ideal partner, the aforementioned psychopath. The Cyclops killer would commit the murder, and Rohan would take the eye.
I think I know who the murderer is.
Was established. This was the origin. Of
somebody
the
we keep forgetting about. Well, we didn't forget about because we saw him a little while ago.
You were assigned to Abyss.
Number 89.
He was born with a brain dysfunction. Due to damage to the posterior pituitary gland, he was unable to properly secrete oxytocin.
Oxytocin is a peptide hormone linked to feelings of love, affection, and trust. It is colloquially referred to as the love hormone. It causes a tranquilizing effect which improves mood and relieves stress. It is normally secreted when the body makes contact with an object of affection, such as an embrace or caress.
I'm sure you know what this implies, but he was unable to feel love in the way that we do. However, he was able to experience a substitute. His brain was wired in such a way that allowed him to feel satisfaction through other means. Due to the unique idiosyncrasies of his brain, he was able to release large amounts of dopamine and endorphins by performing a certain action.
What was it?
Murder.
Dopamine is a hormone linked to the reward system of the brain. The pleasant feeling attained through accomplishment is dopamine. Endorphins are a kind of brain narcotic. They dull pain and create a feeling of happiness.
He got pleasure from killing people?
It's slightly more complicated than that. Killing people was the only way he could get pleasure. He was 12 when he took his first life. That enlightened him to the pleasure of murder, which he would do again and again.
The original Cyclops killer had an accomplice.
There were two Cyclops killers.
And one of them was the former chairman of the Kumakuras, Rohan Kumakura.
Rohan committed suicide by jumping to his death 1 year ago.
I don't buy that.
That means... Computer, tell me this. One of the original killers is dead, I know that. That means one remains. Who is he?
After his fourth murder, he was arrested by the police. They actually picked him up on other charges. But, in any case, he is currently serving a life sentence in Fuchu Prison.
Fuchu Prison?
Yes.
What's his name?
In prison, he doesn't have a name. He's simply called number 89.
I was right!
Who killed Shogun Adami?
I was right!
I love you.
So, now you know why I said that. That the original Cyclops killer couldn't have committed these crimes.
Because he's in jail!
Because one is dead, and the other is behind bars. Neither of them had the opportunity.
So then next, back to Matsushita Diner. Oh, we have to confront Mayumi and... poor woman. She's suffering from dementia, and also her father and now son are dead. The place was silent. It was so quiet, I felt like I could hear the floating dust. I stepped inside. I thought it was empty, but I saw a shadow in the corner of my eye. Oh god, this is gonna be rough. It was Mayumi. It's like watching a decaying old tree cling pathetically to the earth. What a description! Alright. I'm sorry to interrupt, but she ain't gonna talk.
This is your fault.
Uh-oh.
I heard from the police. Because you didn't take care of Iris, my boy Ota got involved.
Date, I looked into the investigation report. Mayumi confirmed Ota's body early this morning.
I see.
I'm sorry. I want to be alone right now. Did you not hear me? I said leave!
Date, let's go. She is in no state to talk.
Yeah, you're right.
Okay, next is Date's house. I don't think there's any neon because it's pretty close. Mizuki's curled up on the sofa. He looked like a small animal frightened by a predator. I guess this is just what we're gonna get for a while.
Mizuki must know about Iris and Ota.
Of course. The news was distributed heavily across the internet, not just in Japan, but worldwide.
Yeah, it was live streams.
3 days ago, Mizuki discovered her mother's body. 2 days ago, her father's. This morning, two of her best friends. It is completely understandable that she is at her mental limit.
I would be too.
Can I be left alone for a while?
Are you okay?
Yeah.
She certainly didn't seem so. But I can't stay by herself forever.
Contact Abyss. See if they can get Mizuki a good counselor.
Understood.
Stayed with her for a little while, but we didn't speak. Having nothing more to say, I left. Yeah, we're just gonna go to all these different houses and exhaust the dialogue options and then just leave. When I visited the Sagan household, I found Hitomi with a hollow look in her eyes. She led me in and asked me to sit on the sofa. I agreed and sat down, but after that I couldn't say a single word. The heavy silence weighed upon both of us.
Iris was my everything. We always went everywhere together. Whether it was buying clothes, or going to the movies, or taking a walk, or going shopping at the supermarket. When she was young, she would just hold one of my fingers. Her hand was too small to hold mine. Then it was two, then three, and finally she could hold my hand.
Why did they throw the heaviest one on us right before the end?
She left my hands altogether. She started crossing her arms, being independent, even though she needed constant attention growing up. Her memories are a part of this room. And always will be. When she was a baby, she fell off that sofa and cried and cried. One day, she tore up her picture book all over the floor here. Another time, she drew with crayons all over the window. She painted my portrait on Mother's Day. Scratches on the floor, chipped plates, burn marks on the table, stains on the cushions. Everything you see. It all holds a memory of her. But why? Oda was one of my students. I taught him in elementary school. I heard it from the police. Oda tried to help Iris and ended up... I don't know what to say. I have no words.
Hitomi, my entire focus is on this case. Is there anything at all you can tell me?
I don't know if this is important, but...
No, please. Tell me.
I may have told you this already. I met Renju's wife Shoko twice before. The first time at the wedding, the second time a month ago. That second time was in the waiting room of the prison.
Prison?
There's an acquaintance of mine from when we were young.
89.
I visit them a few times a year.
Mm-hmm.
By coincidence, I saw Shoko. I don't think she noticed me, but I recognized her as Renju's wife right away. She was there for the same reason I was, to visit one of the inmates.
Do you know who?
No, I don't. We didn't talk.
Which prison?
Fuchu Prison, in Tokyo.
Fuchu?
Prison?
I mean, it's kind of obvious when you really think about it.
I'm sorry to have bothered you. I'll be going now.
I don't know what to do. Thinking about her.
You know what? I now know why this is called the Annihilation Route.
Dante, please, you have to catch.
Nearly every character fucking dies in it. Seems that way. I mean, a good chunk of the cast is gone in this one.
Annihilates your feels.
Yeah, sorry if we haven't been very talkative. Like, this is like the... This is the heaviest it's been so far. Shit. Only one place left to go to. It's Marble. You know, I was gonna give it the saddest Neon we ever did, but it didn't even bother.
Are you okay, honey?
No!
Huh?
About last night. Well, at 3 a.m. anyway.
You know about it?
It's on every channel. You have the face of a ghost. Do you want a glass?
This would make me drink.
I need a drink. I need information. Do you have anything?
Well, let's see. I do have... I suppose you could call it intuition.
Tell me.
The Kumakuras are involved in this case. Remember what I told you before? That there's a relationship between Ren and the Kumakuras? Shoko also has a relationship with them. You know about her dealings with the Kumakuras, right?
So basically, two of the victims are linked to the Kumakuras. That must mean they're involved somehow, right?
Not two. Three.
Three? Iris?
No, not that one. The boy. He came here last night.
Ota?
Yes, from Matsushita Diner. He's linked to the Kumakuras as well.
What?
Have you heard the rumor?
I see, what's it?
Mama told me a similar story to Aiba's. So is Tsujima in the Kawasaki district. Basic idea is this. 8 years ago, Seoul sold his land in the Kawasaki district for 30 billion yen. Half a year later, an explosion at the chemical plant caused the land price to drop drastically. Seoul bought back the land for 1 billion yen, almost like he knew beforehand that the accident was going to happen. Did Seoul blow it up or conspire to blow it up? No, that wouldn't make sense. Seoul wouldn't gain anything from that. He would end up with 29 billion in cash and 1 billion in land. It's a net zero, but there's more to the story.
The Kumakuras own a handful of real estate companies. They, of course, look legit, but they're Yakuza fronts. I'll call those real estate companies the K.E. to keep it simple for you. The K.E. followed in So's footsteps. They bought up land in Kawasaki. Now, back to So. Have you heard of the plans for the casino in Kawasaki? So was the one who came up with it.
I was born and raised in Kawasaki. I remember the landscape of my childhood, and I loved it dearly. But look at Kawasaki now. When I see images of the destruction on television, my heart aches like it's being chopped to pieces. I promise you, I will revive the Kabasaki district at any cost. Casino Town Kabasaki will give new life to the city.
You see what they're doing to Kabasaki? It's terrible. It really is terrible.
He submitted the bills he needed to the National Assembly after drumming up support in the right places.
Really?
The bills passed, and it became an official government initiative.
Decontamination efforts therefore increased at a rapid pace in the Kabasaki district. At the moment, the area is still considered off-limits. However, the air in Kabasaki is currently purified to such an extent that it has no negative effect on the human body.
If the plan goes smoothly, land prices in Kabasaki are going to skyrocket. And all that land is owned by the KE, and by So himself. The land he bought back for $1 billion will be worth 10 times that soon.
He's involved in some shady business.
This is just another rumor, but the chemical plant exploding was no accident. It was done intentionally.
By So and the Kumakuras, you mean?
But there's no hard evidence of that.
Of course not.
It's just gossip. What were we talking about again?
Ota and the Kumakuras.
Oh, right. You know how Matsushita Diner is close to the Kabasaki district? The chemical plant explosion made times hard. Foot traffic went down, sales declined. No wonder it closed down. Ota must hold a grudge. Someone caused that explosion.
Wait a second.
And if it was intentional, oh, he'd hate them even more.
What are you waiting?
That's
what are you planning?
I link Ota to the Kumakuras.
Yeah, I'm thinking of a... So here's what I'm thinking. Do you remember how, like, they wanted to get Ota into school? And they, his father worked himself to the bone to get, money for him, and then he suddenly died?
Oh, explosion?
I think he, like... did stuff with the Kumakuras to get money, and then him dying from exhaustion was being offed. Crazy theory, no.
Thank you,
but I'm just thinking about it.
I don't know if what you told me will lead to anything, but...
Oh, sorry. I didn't mean to waste your time.
No, it was very helpful.
I'm glad I can help, even if it's just a little.
Well then, be seeing you.
Come back anytime.
And we're going back to Abyss headquarters. You mean you might be a Nyom? Nope. No. Return to boss's office of report. But I didn't see her anywhere. I saw that fucking Tanuki though.
Where did she go?
Well, she isn't always here, correct?
True.
Sat down in my usual seat and decided to wait for the boss.
What are you doing?
I thought it would be easier to talk like this.
What do we have to talk about?
A summary of the investigation, perhaps?
What summary? We don't have anything new.
That's not true.
Huh?
I was curious, so I did some research about number 89.
What did she find? You want to find out next time?
Mm-hmm.
On Super Bonus Round?
So mm-hmm.
Thank you guys so much for watching. We'll see you guys then. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye, but spell it with an AI.
No.
Goodbye, everybody.